And if while you're driving, passes me.
Talk about the history of video games. There's a couple games that we have to talk about, like Kong, Pac-Man, and Super Mario Brothers, that really influenced the entire video game industry. And Xevious is one of those titles. Xevious influenced the vertical shooting game genre more than any other game, and is, in my opinion, one of the best video games ever made. And incredibly challenging, frustrating, and enjoyable all at the same time. This game was released in 1982, and is fortunately seeing a comeback on Xbox Live. And I think Xbox Live is tremendous, and the Xbox Live Arcade, bringing back the old school games from the 80s and platformers from the 90s. And I can't say enough good things about Xbox Live. Not only does it bring back these great old school games, but it brings them back high definition. You can play them through your HDMI cable into an HD. It's just tremendous. Xevious is presented in its original native aspect ratio as you would have played it in the arcade, which is like a television laid on its side. It probably looks very familiar to those of you who have played games like Raid. There's so many games in this genre now. As a general rule, I think they're more popular in Japan than they are over here in the States. I think that's unfortunate, because I personally like this genre a great deal. It's challenging, it's fun. As you know on this show, I love being the lone, daring starfighter against countless enemies, impossible odds, on a questionable day mission. Usually, it doesn't matter anymore, because what's the point of this game is to get through it, to have fun, to rack up points, and to shoot things and watch them blow up. Xevious came out in the arcade in 1982, and has since been seen on game systems like the Atari 7800 and the NES. And in fact, the original Classic Game Room series, we reviewed the Atari 7800 version and a version for the PlayStation, which they remade. As you can see from the screen, you have two different weapon options. And that's one of the things that makes Xevious unique. But for starters here, you have your lasers, your twin cannons, and your bombs. So you have to shoot your enemies in the air, and also bomb the enemies on the ground. And they're all shooting at you in different directions, and it's very challenging. What makes this game decidedly different from Raiden 3, for instance, which is one I recently reviewed, is that you can't power up your weapons to have this arsenal that fills the entire screen with your weapons. You're basically limited to the two weapons that you start with. So instead of getting that massive, huge shotgun burst of red bullets that most vertical games have, or a special weapon that you can blow up and then eliminate all enemy fire when it's about to kill you, you really have to rely on some serious skill in dodging the enemy fire. Now, I generally forget the story of Xevious. You can find it online, I'm sure. But you do encounter a couple bosses as you continue on in the game. And wave after wave of the variety of enemies changes on you. And my favorite part of this game, something I've loved since I was a kid and played this on my Atari 7800, is those spinning metal plates that come at you. At the time, those were amazing. That kind of graphics in a video game was just unbelievable. Xevious was way ahead.
lucky.
You can see why it influenced his genre so much.
He has hair, skin, and brown hair.
Just these simple things like putting clothes in the water. You can't just bomb them. You have to actually leave them with your bomb and hope that they run into it. So it requires a lot of skill to hit all the enemies and rack up serious points. And with Xbox Live, of course, they give you the added incentive of going for gamer points, which are addictive and a lot of fun to collect for no apparent reason. The other great thing about Xbox Live, of course, is you can see how your score ranks up against everybody else and friends of yours. What's really incredible about Xevious is that this game came out in 82, and it really doesn't look any different than newer games today. Maybe it's slightly different, but I mean, there's only so much you can really do with a two-dimensional vertical scrolling game before it starts getting ridiculous. And I'm not a big fan of adding in all those three-dimensional polygons and crap floating all over the screen. I think keeping it simple like this is the way to go. And that's why I like Xevious so much. The game's a great game. I'm generally not a huge fan of using the Xbox 360 controller on this game. It's definitely challenging. I prefer the arcade-style joystick and buttons, but you know, what are you going to do when you just don't have a stand-up Xevious arcade machine in your basement? Xbox Live is about the best thing you can have. So it does require some skill to hammer away at the button, and also remember to bomb your enemies at a precise time. This is not a game where you can just hold down the fire button. It does give you an option to do a manual shot where you just fire at the rate that I'm firing at now, and also I use my other trigger to hold down the auto fire. So if a wave of enemies comes at me, I hold down that trigger and it puts off machine gun burst of shots. But you cannot just hold down a consistent auto fire for the entire game. For whatever reason, the music, although it just repeats itself over and over again, it never gets old. And maybe that's just that awesome. Here are the metal plates. And just look at those. 20 years ago, that was incredible.
This is where I control yourself because of the competition.
They're tough, too. You have to dodge those things. You can't blow them up, so you have to dodge them. And then the enemy fire is coming at you, and then you know, you get caught in between the enemy fire and the spinning metal plates, and it kills you. I love to see the resurgence in arcade titles on Xbox Live. And they don't cost much on Xbox Live. A game like this is only about $5, and it really has infinite replay value. Even if you went out to find this for your Atari 7800 or NES, it would still cost you at least $5 or $6 when you add in the shipping costs.
$7, $6, $8.
I'm by no means the greatest Xevious player in the world. In fact, I'd like to get a lot better at this game because it really is one of my favorite games and always has been. Just need to find the time to sit down and get back into it.
He's away. The Buzzy.
That's one that I grew up with and had when I was a kid. And Xevious was up there with Robotron 2084 as my favorite game on the Atari 1700. I've played it hours and hours and hours and hours. And I'm glad to see that there's still a lot of interest in Xevious today. If you like this genre, you've never played Xevious before, you owe it to yourself, pick this game up on Xbox Live, or the 7800, or the NES, and you've got to play Xevious. If you're really hardcore,
and 1, 4, 3, and only. This is where wooden buzzer was.
Where's all the furniture? Like, what outside? Because you guys see me as Xevious. She may start to get red and get mad at you. Well, why do you need furniture when you have a Xevious machine?
There you go, you try.
Play Xevious. It's only common sense.
Bad.
It's like replacing the dining room table with the cocktail version of Miss
Xevious.
Circumstances.
And we're forced to be at Disney. 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 That's on green tea. And we'll force me in.
Listen for the best. My reputation's never been worse, so you must like me for me. We can't make any promises now, can we, babe? But you can make me dream. Dive bar on the east side, where you at? Pawn lights at my nightstand in the black. Come here, you can meet me in the back. Dark jeans and your Nikes, look at you. Oh damn, if I seen that color blue. Just think of the fun things we could do. Cause I like. Is it cool that I said all that? Is it too soon to do this yet? Cause I know that it's delicate.
Thank you. Officer A7A. B14B.
Sorry, Bonnie.